بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا محمد بن عبد الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وقال تعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا قيل لكم تفسحوا في المجالس فافسحوا يفسح الله لكم وإذا قيل انشزوا فانشزوا يرفع الله الذين آمنوا منكم والذين أوتوا العلم درجات والله بما تعملون خبير. صدق الله العظيم. All praise and thanks be to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher and protector. May the choicest of his blessings and salutations be upon our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. My beloved principal, Sheikh Fazil Farooq, our chief guest who has flown in all the way from South Africa, Mufti Abdul Qadir Hussain, our guest of honor, the president of the Al Salam Jam'iyatul Ulama, Mufti Rizvi, the managing director of our institute, Al-Hajj Najmuddin, my beloved teachers, respected ulama, distinguished parents, guests, my fellow students, brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. First and foremost, I thank Allah the Almighty for blessing me with this opportunity where I get to represent my class on this auspicious and joyous occasion and share a few words on behalf of all of them with my friends and peers. My dear respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, let me take you all on a stroll down memory lane. I still remember 7 years back, I used to meet my principal often for Jum'ah Salah, and the only thing I used to ask him was, Maulana, when is your institute opening its doors? Maulana, when is your institute opening its doors? And then I remember the night, as if it was last night, when Maulana called my beloved father and he asked him to bring me to his house. I still remember how excited I was until I reached Maulana's house. It was a kind of an interview plus advice plus a friendly chat where he finally told me that he was going to begin his institute and that I was to be the first student. Allahu Akbar. I consider that a great privilege. May Almighty Allah bless him immensely for that. That was the day, my dear respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, that I took my very first step in this beautiful voyage across the oceans of knowledge. And indeed, it was a beautiful voyage that me and my fellow classmates enjoyed immensely, as it is something that we, and it is something that we are going to miss dearly for the rest of our lives. For the ship that we sailed in was our beloved institute. An institute like none other, my dear respected elders, brothers in Islam. An institute that changed the complete system of Islamic education in this country to the better. It offered us the very best that it had. The first few years are still fresh and golden chapters in our memories. I still remember Sheikh Ismail, a Nigerian teacher of ours, who is no longer with us, as he is currently teaching in another country. May Almighty Allah bless him. For he gave us all that he had in regard to his valuable advice, time and knowledge. Likewise, Mufti Shafiq, who is with us today, he used to take the very first period in the morning. I still remember the first lesson that he taught us from the book, Qiraatul Wadiha, about Mubtada and Khabar, about the subject and the predicate in the Arabic language. It seemed like Greek to me at that time, But he, on the other hand, being a fantastic teacher, mashallah, may Almighty Allah bless him and reward him, he simplified it so beautifully for us and taught us the easiest way to differentiate between the mubtada and the khabar is through the is. The is that is between two nouns in a sentence, for example. Likewise, Maulana Saad, a very soft, loving and kind teacher who taught us all to observe things very carefully and derive lessons from many things that are around us that we take for granted most of the time. And Maulana Mu'al, a humble teacher who used to be behind us all the time emphasizing on the sunnahs of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and likewise checking on our hair all the time. May Almighty Allah reward him and grant him a high station in Jannah. My dear respected elders and brothers and sisters in Islam, on a more serious note, this institute was a home away from home for us. Even though many were skeptical about it in the beginning, many people predicted that this day scholar system which had been introduced would never be a success. Or even if it did, the products of this system would never be up to par. But Allah's plan and decree was different. Today, the seven of us standing in front of you all with the power of Allah, with the decree of Allah, as graduates from this prestigious institute is living proof to the hard work of our beloved principal and our noble teachers who worked hard, who toiled day and night in polishing and equipping us to become scholars who would fear Almighty Allah and be conscious of Him at all moments and serve the Ummah of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the very best of ways. Finally, as a closing note, and also in accordance to the words of our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which is recorded in Ahmad and Tirmidhi, مَنْ لَمْ يَشْكُرِ النَّاسَ لَمْ يَشْكُرِ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. He who has not thanked the people has not thanked Allah the Almighty. So we, the graduates of 2013, would like to thank our beloved principal from the bottom of our hearts for choosing us and accepting us into his institute, and for all the wisdom and knowledge that he has shared with us, and likewise for all the kindness that he has shown us from the very first day. May Almighty Allah bless him and grant him the very best in this world and the hereafter. Ameen. And then we would like to thank all of our noble teachers who imparted so much of their hard-earned knowledge to us. And even if it be that they taught us just an alif, we are indebted to them for our whole lives. And then we would like to extend a heartfelt gratitude to the management of our institute, who is none other than Najmuddin Uncle, who is the pillar and the backbone of our institute. May Almighty Allah reward him immensely for all that he has done and grant him handsome profits in the Akhirah for the fantastic investments he has made in Kulliyatul Ain and Al-Ma'hadul Islamiyul Alami. And we would like to thank all of our beloved parents who are rocks of perseverance during the calm and during the storm throughout our academic journeys. For if not for them, we would not be the individuals who we are today, if not for their intentions, if not for their du'as, and we would indeed be lost without them. May Almighty Allah reward them with the highest stations in Jannah. And also, I would like to take a personal moment to thank my beloved parents and my two sisters who helped me a lot, who supported me throughout my academic journey, and finally my beloved and loving wife who helped me a great deal in achieving all that I have achieved with the help of Almighty Allah. And with that I conclude. May Almighty Allah bless this institute, may Almighty Allah bless the graduates of this institute and the students of this institute, and may He the Almighty utilize every drop of blood of ours for his deen locally and internationally. Wa akhir da'wayan, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Jazakum Allahu khair for your